Please get ready for a dictation of part 4 of the Supreme Court judgment in criminal appellate jurisdiction, criminal appeal numbers 1140 and 1141 of 2010. 5 seconds. Start. It is thus a well crystallized principle that if two views are possible, the High Court ought not to interfere with the trial court's judgment. However, such a precautionary principle cannot be overstretched to portray that the contours of appeal against acquittal under Section 378 CRPC are limited to seeing whether or not the trial court's view was impossible. It was equally well settled that there is no bar on the High Court's power to reappreciate evidence in an appeal against acquittal. This court has held in a catena of decisions, including Chandrappa versus State of Karnataka, State of Andhra Pradesh versus M. Madhusudan Rao, and Raveen Kumar versus State of Himachal Pradesh, that the CRPC does not differentiate in the power, scope, jurisdiction, or limitation between appeals against judgments of conviction or acquittal, and that the appellate court is free to consider on both fact and law, despite the self-restraint that has been ingrained into practice while dealing with orders of acquittal, where there is a double presumption of innocence of the accused. The trial court in an instant case rightly observed that the evidence was chaotic with regard to many accused persons and no definite view could be formed regarding their participation. The High Court also shared the view of the trial court and expressed concern regarding the exaggerations and contradictions within the evidence. Keeping in mind the attempts by the prosecution witnesses to implicate numerous people, the High Court delineated the strands of consistent evidence against some of the accused which were overlooked by the trial court amid the chaos. While analyzing the witness statements and other evidence, we will now consider whether the High Court did so correctly. Complainant Nathar Singh, PW1, deposed that when the accused persons broke open the door and entered their house, Buddhi Singh, Achhar Singh, Narinder Singh were armed with axes. Prakash had a spear. Sodha Ram had a sickle, and other accused were bearing sticks. While mentioning the present appellants, he said that Buddhi Singh, accused, gave 2 axe blows on the head of my mother, while Narinder, accused, gave 2 axe blows, one above the left ear and second below the left ear of my mother, and my mother Swari Devi died on the spot. Achhar Singh and Sodhas also gave blows of draught and axe to my father. As a result of the beatings, my father became unconscious and fell down. Hem Singh and Jai Singh, accused, gave me danda blows. It was also mentioned that the accused had broken the door, windows and utensils. He then described how he went to the Pradhan's house at 2 a.m. and later to the far away police station on foot and lodged the FIR at about 8 to 9 a.m. the next day. The next morning, he also mentioned that prior animosity existed between the parties because Buddhi Singh and Narinder Singh wanted to purchase the land where he had constructed a house and that his father, Beli Ram, had previously filed a case against the accused persons in which they had been acquitted. Meera Devi, PW 11, the daughter-in-law of the deceased, stated in her testimony that Buddhi Singh and Narinder Singh were armed with axes while Prakash carried a spear and Sodharam carried a sickle. She said that Buddhi Singh accused gave two blows of axe on the head of my mother-in-law, Shrimati Swari Devi, on which my mother-in-law raised cry. Narinder Singh accused gave two blows of axe on the ear of my mother-in-law and my mother-in-law fell down and died. Narinder Singh gave blow from backside of the axe to Beli Ram on his face and Achar Singh gave blow of axe on the neck of Beli Ram. Sodha Ram gave draught blow on the leg of my father-in-law, Beli Ram. Jai Singh and Hem Singh gave danda blow to my husband, Netar Singh. She stated that her husband escaped to the roof, reported the matter to the Pradhan and came back with the police the next day. Her husband and father-in-law were taken for medical examination and her mother-in-law's body was sent for post-mortem. During her cross-examination, she mentioned that the police came at about 8 to 9 a.m. in the morning. Injured witness Beli Ram was also examined and he stated that Buddhi Singh, Narinder and Achar Singh came bearing axes while Prakash had a spear. Sodharam had a sickle and Jai and Hem Singh were armed with sticks. While describing the attacks, he said that Buddhi Singh gave two blows of axe on the head of my wife, Swari Devi, and two blows of axe were given by Narinder near the ear of my wife, and my wife died on the spot. Achar Singh, accused, gave axe blow on the backside of my head, while Sodha, accused, gave draught blow on my leg. Netar Singh was given beatings by Jai Singh and Hem Singh with danda and stones. He added that his son escaped through the roof. It was mentioned that the accused persons had formed a committee to boycott them and thus nobody from the village gave evidence in their favor. He also disclosed that Narinder Singh, accused, also gave blunt side of the axe on my face near ear. Thereafter, he fell unconscious and was medically examined at the hospital. Stop.